Sometimes people who are new to CAM have a problem understanding the concept of a boundary. I like to refer to a boundary as a fence, and in our example here, this fence is keeping the sheep out of a certain area. In the same way, a boundary will keep a cutting tool inside or outside of a certain area that we define with the boundary shape itself. In some ways, a boundary is similar to a sketch. As we can see on the left-hand side, a closed sketch defines an area to be extruded into a solid body. Whereas on the right side, a boundary defines the containment area for the cutting tool. The boundary keeps the cutting tool within that area. There are three popular ways to create a boundary in Solid Edge CAM Pro. The first method is by simply picking points. Here, we're demonstrating cursor location picks on the graphic screen. The second method is by using curves or edges of an existing solid body. The third method, and perhaps the easiest, is by selecting a face. Now that you know about boundaries, I'm happy to tell you that most of the time you don't need them in Solid Edge CAM Pro, as our software has been consistently enhanced over the years. 20 years ago, we would use an operation like planer mill to create a boundary to describe this pocket. We set the options and create the boundary. Very useful, but it requires a high degree of boundary knowledge to do it properly. Today, we have better operations like floor and wall milling. With floor and wall milling, we just choose the face of the floor and automatic walls. We can quickly machine the area without a boundary. In a future quick tip, we will look at an instance where it is necessary to create a boundary. Thanks for watching.